I'm Duke Boys. I got him this time. I love it.
I've done some small work on the sides of the elevated terrain bit by adding, hacking away some of the plaster. And then I made some grooves, stuck on two pieces of wood, some strips, and it's still falling off, the pieces of plaster, that's not real biggie. It's going to be repainted again and again and again. So nothing will more fall off. And the reason I have put these pieces of wood on are quite simple. As you see, it helps to elevate the car from the ramp. Because if it wouldn't put those pieces of wood over there, it would just fall off. And I can readjust it a little bit. Of course, I still need to put the wheels on. And I'm going to simulate the dust cloud, which will in turn hide these pieces of wood. Even though the car isn't finished yet, I'm going to install the decals. I'm going to place the decals. And why are we going to do that? Well, as you know, the car is going to be placed on a diorama. And as you see, I've already installed the tires and these pieces of plastic, and I'll explain why I installed these pieces of plastic later. But as you can see on the tires, I have already added some light brown smudges, because it's going to be simulated that it is driving over a dusty field, a dusty road, which of course means that dust is going to be on the surface of the car. And considering of course that the decals or the any kind of paint is going to be underneath all that dust, we need to install the decals first. And in order to do so, I have already cut out one of the decals. It's going to be on the side door. And I'm going to dip it in a jar or a cup of rather hot water. And I'll let it leave on this paint jar for a few minutes. And while I'm doing that, I'm just going to cut off another piece of decal while the other one is setting. And while that is setting, I can actually dip in a new decal in the water and have that also set for a few minutes. Oops, it's fell out. Okay. So here we have this decal. I'm using the photo on the box art to locate where it's going to go. It's going to go over here on the door. I'm going to use the point of the scissors to it's already in the correct position. Maybe a bit higher. I can see on the box art that this line goes on the same line as the silver strip, which I've removed from the door. Okay, it's in the correct position. Now I'm going to use a piece of cloth and press on the decal, and then also pressing any water underneath the decal. And finally I'm going to use a Q-tip and try to wipe off any excess liquid which is still underneath the decal. Okay. And while I was waiting, I can now install the other decal which goes underneath this one. Okay, I'm going to use the point of the scissors again to put it into position. Okay, and hey presto, now when all the decals have been added, I'm going to use some sealant over the decals to make sure that they stay in place. Single camera only. It's time to glue the police car now onto the diorama set. As you can see, I've added a few little things like grass and stuff and stones like that. It's not finished yet, the diorama. It still needs some work, and a lot of the grass is still, well, you can still pull it loose from the glue. I used some hot glue for these grass sections and some standard normal glue for the stones and the little piece of grass, which all are going to be airbrushed later on in a different color. I just noticed that this is loose. No, it's not loose. Okay. So, what I'm going to do now is glue on this car. I have already found the correct position for the wooden rods. They're going over here. And I have already also taken care of the cables which are going in the hole. So these cables are emerging on the bottom. So that's all taken care of. So what I need to do now is add a lot of glue. This plastic has gone loose, I see. Well, add some hot glue to the plastic first. Hello, are you on, Mr. Hot Glue Machine? Yes, apparently we are on. Okay, hold on, I'll have some glue on the... It's not... Oh, there it is. I was waiting for the glue to come out. A lot of glue. I need a lot of glue. You're not gonna see it anyway later on. So, lots of glue. Stick it on. It's already getting stuck on, okay. So, now as the police car has been glued into a position, and it's still not finished, but before I can do anything else, I will need to install the electronics. As I said earlier, I have found a small box to house the electronics, which I have over here. But first I need to make sure that the box itself is in position. So I'm probably gonna see if it will fit. And if it does, I will simply glue in the bottom section. And, oh, it does fit. You just have to drop it in. All right. This is new. Now I need to get it out so I get the glue in. And that is going to be difficult. That is going to be difficult. Will I be able to close the box when the... Perhaps. Okay, I need to get this... Well, blow me to the moon. So this goes out like that, easily. Okay, forget everything I said. So, I'm going to use some glue, which is, in this case, heavy-duty... what is it called, actually? Well, it's called... give me a few seconds. It's called... Montage kit, which is in English is fixing kit, which is a thick glue you use for DIY projects. And I just found out that I did it wrong. This is supposed to be going in because there's a letter, there's a text stencil over here. Oh well. So I'm gonna put this in. And that will need to dry first before I can do anything else. And then I'll be able to place in this. Now, as you can see, there are two cables coming in over here. One is for the left and one is for the right light of the car. It doesn't make any difference which one is which. So I need to remove the LEDs, the test LEDs, one by one, and replace them with these cables. I've already checked. We need a very powerful battery to get these lights running, because I checked earlier on a battery which was almost out of power. The test LEDs worked, but the lights on top of the police car didn't. So I really need a very full new battery for it to run. I'm also probably going to need to cut some holes to get these cables through. Okay, but let's make sure that this is dry first before I can do anything else. Okay, all the electronics are finally in. It took some time, as I told you earlier, because some cables were breaking, but this is what I did. Let me turn around on the bottom side. Okay, so the battery pack is glued in, although it's still loose, so I need to find out why this isn't working. Okay, well, that's not a real problem. I can fix that later. These two red cables, they are once again being pulled through the hole which I've made earlier. They come on the bottom of the car. I have pulled them forward with a pincet. I'm not quite sure what this thing is called in English, but okay. And I've pulled them up towards the engine bay. Here they are coming up, and they are now linked into a switch which is being positioned right here. It's a on-off switch, and I tried to use screws to put it into place, but that wouldn't work, so I just used a lot of hot glue. In here, as you can see, and now it's in place. That does, of course, mean that the inevitable thing is coming, and that is we have to fix or glue in the hood of the car. Now I'm going to explain why I've been using these pieces of plastic on the bottom of the police car. And I'm using these. These are pieces of cotton. And what I'm doing is I am stretching them out. Oops, let me give you a bit more room. Stretching them out as much as I can. And then I'm gluing them on top of those plastic strips. And then I'm gonna paint them in the same color as the dust of the road, so it actually looks like the car is dusting up. As you can see, it's a bit too big. Now let me see if I can make it a bit more elongated. It does mean, of course, that I will need to airbrush a lot of this dust along the car. As you can see, I have made a few alterations. I had made the dust clouds with the wheels, and well, they looked far too big. I checked some photographs of the TV series, some stills, and no, they were far too big. They looked really fake. I removed the dust clouds and the plastic. Unfortunately, the front wheels broke off, so I had to repair these. And I also removed one of the wooden rods over here, that was far too prominent. So I only get one rod, and that's sufficient to support the car anyway. There's still some plastic over here in the back. Oh, over here you can see. I will remove that with this thing. Hopefully I will not be... I'll wait and use a knife for that. So what I'm going to do, hold on, let me move the camera a bit. Let me first start with adding the, because I forgot, the headlights. They still have to be added. And then I'll just use a little bit, a very tiny bit of this these cottons. And oops, let me see if I can put it on in shot and do only a very small bit. But I will add, however, and that was already planned, is some breaking like a wooden fence which is breaking as the car is careening over the edge. So there will be some additional things you can actually see instead of the large amount of fluff you can see. It's far too large, so forget that. I might be using maybe some behind here, maybe, but before I do that, I also need to add the rear lights. So let's start with adding those lights and then see if I can actually add the smaller bits of fluff. I just got a great idea. A couple of months ago, I bought myself this spray can from a local DIY shop. It's a spray can which gives a stone-like effect, so you can spray it on pots and so forth to make it look like a stone. And the effect you get is, let me see, this is the cap of the spray can. I always have problems with this spray can because it doesn't give me exactly the results I want. However, I just figured out if I could use this to spray the sides and certain other points of the diorama for Roscoe's police car. I of course need to make sure that the police car itself is covered, in this case by a towel, so it doesn't get much of the spray itself. And it will take a long time to dry, but at least you get some sort of a rough pattern, a 3D pattern, which is, well, let me see if I can actually show you. Hold on. I've already done the sides and part of the top. Now it does look like it's been snowing, but I'm going to spray, of course, some mud like colors over it, and I did spray a bit on the car, but there's no problem because I'm going to spray some mud on there as well. So all I need to do is make sure that this is dry, and then I can spray it in color, and I think it will work. Okay, I have now sprayed that kind of stone-like material all over the display, and then sprayed it in several coats of light brown, like mud and stuff like that. And I believe it came out really well indeed. I've also included a few strips of, a few of these broken fence pieces, one on this side as well, and I even include one on the front of the car. I have reduced the amount of fluff on the back, on the wheels, and I think it looks very well. There's only one thing now which bugs me, or two things actually. One of them is the bottom, where I have glued in the battery pack, and unfortunately it's glued in too, how should I put it, not too high but too low, which means that the feet which I had installed are not big enough, so I need to install a new feet which are a bit higher, so this won't hit the floor of the table where the model is being placed on. The other thing that bothers me, and that has to do with the model itself, are the mirrors, the side mirrors. There are two of them, of course, included. Here's one of them. You need to glue them on the side of the doors, and as you can see, there is a small little piece over here where I've tried it. The problem is with this model, and this is very weird, is there is absolutely no indication how you to glue them. There is no pin, there is no hole, there is nothing on both the mirror or on the car which tells you where to glue them or even how to glue them. So you need to glue them on the car body, and well, that sometimes works, but in most cases it just falls off again. That is really a small bit of complaint about this kit, which on the whole is quite well made, but yeah, that is really a bummer. So I need to try this glues again. I was thinking of making a pin myself, but It's not gonna work. Let's try it. Just put some glue. And with that, it is finished. The Roscoe's police car. The jumping version which I've made. Yeah, let me zoom out a bit so you can see the whole model. So here it is, the jumping version. I switched on the lights, as you can see. These are, well, as I said, they're a bit weak, unfortunate. Yeah, nothing can be done about that now. So what I've done in the last couple of days, I have, as you've seen, I have, well, let me get you a bit more lights. This is a bit too dark. Let me switch off these lights first. And then we switch off a bit more lights in the room so you can actually see it better. There we are. So as I said, I made the wooden fence parts over here, and last thing I did, I glued on the side mirrors, and I had to really turn them towards the frame of the car, because that's the only gripe I have on this kit, those side mirrors. There are no actually connection points on how to connect those side mirrors to the car. So the only way I could actually fix it is gluing with super glue on the body and a bit on the frame. So it's now stuck. But for on the whole, I think it's a very nice kit. Oh, there's another gripe I have, and that's the release of these kits. The kits was originally released by MPC, and then it had a red and blue light. I got the Airfix version, which is probably for the European market, and that only had the two red lights, and that's really unfortunate. I do not understand why they did that. There's also a box containing a first aid kit and a radio or something like that, which, as far as I can judge from the American MPC version, gets placed in the boot or the trunk of the car. Which you can open, and you can see this model doesn't have a opening trunk, lid, boot, whatever. So the instruction manual suggests you have to put that box with the radio and the first aid kit on the back seat, which I find very strange, so I didn't actually include that. So as I said, on the whole, yes, it's a very nice kit, bar a few problems. If you can find it, try to get the American, the MPC version. It has the better lights, and perhaps it even has a opening trunk of the car. Funny thing, of course, is that the only thing that could open on the car was the hood, and that had to be glued in place, so you can't see the engine which you've made, but, well, okay, you can actually make it, of course, with the hood open, with some fiddling. Let me see if we can actually zoom in on Mr. Roscoe P. Coltrane himself. There he is. He's not really happy what happens at the moment. He's jumping off the cliff. Well, don't worry about him. He'll be okay. He'll be back in the next episode. So, as I said, would I advise this kit? Where is it? Would I advise this kit? Well, yeah. Yeah, actually I would. As I said, the only graphs I had were the headlights, and, no, not the headlights, the mirrors on the side, and the strange colors of the police lights on top. There was also a part which you had to glue on the window, which looked like a siren or not. I'm not quite sure what it was. It wasn't explained in the instruction booklet what it was, so I forgot with making that. So, thank you for watching, and, well, hopefully we'll see each other next time for a new project. I'm not quite sure what we're going to build next time, but, well, thank you for watching, and bye!